Nanti zaman now.
Love.
Oke. Yes. Oke. Teman-teman balik lagi kali ini. Seperti biasa kita punya satu apa namanya mas tradisi ya, tradisi profesor kita, profesor yang luar biasa, karena kalau habis bimbingan itu selalu bercengkrama, diskusi banyak hal. Dan sore hari ini kita nongkrong di McD sama kawan saya tadi, Mas Muzakir.
Halo, sore.
Lagi dinasihatin Prof, jangan kayak terciduk gitu. Hai Prof, how are you? Hey. All Indonesian friends wanna see your face. No, no. Prof, please. Hai Prof Rifani.
Hello.
I just want to ask one question.
Yeah.
Without that glass.
I'm right, but I'm a cover agent.
you look like, you know, like kalau orang masuk penjara tuh kayak koruptor.
Oh, enggak apa-apa koruptor. I don't want to be officially recognized. So sepandai Facebook buat facial recognition, to me they have to do double algorithm.
Prof Rif, your message to Indonesian young generation as a Malaysian professor, or the one who want to take a PhD level, what's your message? Please without that class. It's
very, you haven't done PhD yet? Don't do your PhD. It's still early to quit. Quit your PhD now.
One message.
Okay, one message. No. Find a supervisor that has good record for passing the PhD student.
Okay. Is that all?
That's it.
Okay.
Join a winning team.
Join a winning team.
Yes.
Mas, benar nggak? Apa maksud Prof Rif tadi?
Coba saya miss tadi ya, Kak.
Kebiasaan nih, banyakan makan Americano dia. Can you explain one more, Prof?
What?
Yeah, karena Mas Muzakir belum dengar tadi.
Join a winning team. The best is not to do your PhD. That's the best thing.
Yeah.
So if you can quit your PhD, quit. But if you really want to do your PhD, which is a hard thing to do, PhD is not easy thing to do.
It's not easy things to do.
It's not easy. It's not easy.
Why?
So if you still want to do your PhD, find a supervisor who has good track record.
Yeah. Wow.
Find a coach who can really make you succeed. If not, quit your PhD. Don't waste your time.
Wow.
Take the money and pursue something else.
Wow.
Money and time. Don't waste.
But sometimes the school or the university just give them or just throw away the status of the professor to the student. So what can they do? I mean, like they have no choice to pick the right professor or the right person to
quit the university.
It's a very straight to the point.
There are two reasons to do PhD. Two reasons. One, because you're in the academic field, you need it for your career. Two, because you find it is asset visualization.
Yeah.
If you want to have knowledge, go to the library. You can read. You do not need a PhD. Right? If you want to research, you know, join the research team. You don't have to do a PhD. But if you need to be in academic field, PhD counts. Kalau dulu lihat degree saja, kemudian lihat S2, sekarang lihat S3. So if you are in the academic field, either you're lecturer or you're even in USM, they are now the registrar as a PhD, is Dr. Musa. Even the treasurer, bendahara, ada PhD. Right. Because you're in academic field, academic world, then look at those things. Kita ambil pedang panas sebelah mata aja gitu.
Okay.
Kalau dunia persilatan, harus orang yang bersilat lah.
Okay, yeah.
Ada kalau enggak apa aja kan? Kalau tidak ada apa, if you're interested in cooking, don't join persilatan. Yeah. But if you're academic field, then it's a must, almost.
Karena Mas Muzakir ini dosen, jadi harus.
Harus, harus. Atau self-actualization. If not, forget about PhD. Don't waste your time. Don't do your PhD.
Oh.
Quit while you can.
What is the most difficult part being PhD? The most difficult part?
There are five difficult parts.
Wow. Even not one, but five. One.
The first one, deciding your topic.
Okay.
I have friends who change his topic. Remember, this year you ask, it's a different topic. Next year you ask, it's a different topic. So, finding the right topic is more. Itu tapi biasanya kalau orang Asia itu tidak begitu bermasalah lah dia semua. Biasanya kalau orang di luar itu, orang negara Asia ini bisa itu bisa kan itu. Biasa.
Number two.
What is it? I think that one of the biggest thing about number two is to find the theoretical value.
You mean that fill the gap of
theoretical vacuum. Number three
is to find the research that fits the research objective, research question. Karena kalau you have data access problem, you won't have problem getting it. So you come up with a great research problem with a good theoretical vacuum, good research questions. Memang all research is about research questions. But research questions kita tu menanya soalan yang yang susah mau dijawab, karena access di data itu susah. Contohnya, what is the working culture of intelligence community. Or you come up with something that one particular ethnic group yang tidak suka mau beri input. Ethnic group ini enggak mau. Apalagi kalau orangnya dia kulit, contohnya lah, contoh kan. Tapi saya bukan konteks, bisa fikirkan konteks Asia. Tapi konteks lah. Dia researcher kulit hitam. Dia mau tanya orang kulit putih, itu bisa ada social media. So data block, data access.
Number 4.
So find a case or survey or sample that you can access.
Okay, data access. Number 4.
Lack of data.
Number 5. Last point.
Lack of data is actually probably the killer.
Either you have a quantitative or qualitative.
That is the killer.
The data.
Because if you have a lot of data, it's very, 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 very hard for the examiner to fail you.
Okay.
Contohnya misalkan saya di awal theory vacuum, lalu problematizing ideas dan making an objective itu 2 tahun setengah, itu doang. Kumpulin data 2 tahun. In total now 5 years. 5 tahun.
Kalau Mas Muzakir udah punya anak 3 kali 5 tahun, 5 tahun. Ya. Tapi itu prosesnya ya, Prof, yang harus jalanin ya. Itu that's the process, right?
Yeah. And the problem is kalau PhD itu selalu terlalu gampang.
Mm-hmm.
Mungkin PhD ini jangan bagus. Mungkin.
Kalau PhD,
I read PhD. Right?
Okay.
When I was in UK.
Right?
Okay. In some universities.
Okay.
I do not want to name the universities.
Okay.
Right? Dia kasih saya baca ini PhD, tetapi kelihatannya seperti master saja.
Wow.
And I'm concerned when the lecturer comes back, the lecturer teaches students, they bring at a very low standard to the students. And that's my concern.
So you mean not every
university is the same?
No,
not at all. Saya kenal ada teman di university ini, lulusan saya, dia fail, pergi ke sana dia dapat 3.5, 3.2, 3.3. Datang balik, fail. Pergi balik, naik lagi. Oh. Ini universiti bukan universiti lokal, universiti sana. Wow. Di Amerika apa sebab. Oh. Dan bisa ada yang lulus universiti itu bisa jadi rektor juga ada. Oh. Daripada universitas gitu. Dia tak maksud.
So it dependable.
Eh? It depends. So it depends on the university, it depends on the supervisor as well. Right? It depends on the department. Not all the universities are good. Not all the departments in the university is good. Not all supervisors in the department is good. So you got to look for it. Tetapi bukannya semuanya university di sekolah tinggi. Sekolah tinggi di Jogja aja.
One of the best thesis in best, LSE.
Bukan one of the best thesis.
In London School of Economics.
He's my junior, but not my year. Yeah. He went back in Indonesia, dia mengajarnya di sekolah tinggi aja. Tetapi thesisnya sangat bagus, orangnya sangat bagus, supervisornya suka.
Apa faktornya? Kenapa dia bisa kayak gitu?
So, pokoknya di situ ialah pokok lah, Harvard is Harvard lah kan. Tetapi selain dari Harvard, Yale, Cambridge, Oxford dan sebagainya, ada universitas-universitas yang lainnya mungkin kurang lebih sama ya. Jadi kita harus mencari orangnya kan. Tidak semestinya dari universitas ini semuanya bagus atau semua di sana semuanya tidak bagus. Tetapi kita harus pintar-pintar mencari.
Okay, so last statement from Dr. Rif. Amin ya Allah, amin.
Di sini kok kelihatan seperti
dokter di Bali. Di sini saya lihat ketika di ruangan, di center, dan saya lihat ditulis dengan PhD dokter. Dan saya lihat juga ada orang mungkin yang berhenti atau proses lain juga di belakangnya tidak menyantumkan PhD, tapi kok dokter.
Kurang ya lulusan PhD program, tapi ketika mencantumkan nama tadi itu dok-dok-dok bukan menggunakan dok-dok ya dokter Rifani Mustafi. Saya lihat dalam pencantuman itu tidak mencantumkan Rifani Mustafi
PhD. I mean like why didn't prefer to choose using PhD using doctor rather than their PhD title in Malaysia or I mean like is there
into context in Malaysia biasanya kalau dia punya title lah doctor atau formal dia doctor professor doctor gitu kan. Kalau sudah doktor PhD itu sudah redundant gitu. Tetapi kalau amalan yang bagus itu enggak pakai doktor atau diploma dia kalau di academic world. Oh. Kalau biasanya tetapi tergantung juga lah academic world di mana kan. Amalan kalau di US itu doktor jarang dipakai. Jarang kalau US lah. PhD mungkin di akhirnya itu di PhD. Kalau di US. Jadi kalau yang dokter itu jarang lah dipakai dokter, jarang pakai orang dokter. Jadi kalau nama ada PhD, ada. Jadi kalau sudah ada dokter, PhD itu tidak pakai lagi. Gitu.
Kalau biasanya?
Kalau di Malaysia, kalau ada dokter, PhD itu redundant lah, tak perlu dia. Enggak,
maksudnya kalau di Malaysia, kalau luar negeri itu menggunakan PhD.
Kalau ke luar negeri, title tidak penting.
Tidak penting. Saya tanya kalau di Malaysia ini dokter yang sering dipakai apakah mesin tolong ya? Ada dokter di mana? Dokter PhD. Apakah dia sering digunakan dalam penyebutan baru ya? Dan secara formal surat surat itu menggunakan kepada yang terhormat Rifani Mustafi PhD atau kepada yang terhormat Dokter Rifani Mustafi.
Full title. Nama resmi ya?
Yang resmi yang mana?
Yang resmi ya, kan? Resmi ya, seperti ni lah, Profesor Madya Dr. Azim Farouk.
Oh,
Profesor Madya Dr. Azim Farouk.
Dr. ya.
Jadi
dia
pakai PhD
ya.
Dia pakai PhD. Jadi kalau Prof Ri berarti Associate Profesor Rifani Bustami.
Associate Profesor Dr. Rifani Bustami.
Associate Profesor Dr. Muhammad Rifani Bustami. Oke, oke. Last statement, Prof. For last statement for young generation, Indonesian young generation. You as a Malaysian who also have Indonesian blood.
Okay. What is it? I think three things. One is that you strive to change what must change. You have to strive to protect what you must protect. Heritage, good heritage,
yeah.
Good values, good traditions.
Yeah.
Not all that is old is bad, right? But there are a lot of new things you should try. You can make a lot of mistakes. It's good to make mistakes when you're young, because people are much more forgiving and all that. I think that the third one is, I think the most important part is to learn to be build relationships, build good relationships, especially if you're talking about Indonesia, we'll talk about the Nusantara spirit, right?
Nusantara spirit.
Yeah, don't forget that we were once one from Philippines, Indonesia, Brunei, Malaysia, Singapura. Nah,
pada dasar kita semua dulu satu.
Satu,
one line.
Dulu. Kita dulu pentas Sunda, penua Sunda dulu kan. Satu dulu, kemudian kita pecah. Kemudian penjajah datang pecahkan kita. So, we want to bangkitkan
persaudaraan
kita dengan mencari wawasan baru dan juga memelihara warisan kita yang
luar biasa. Opposite and let you know, merdeka. Okay, thanks Rob. Bye.